It's a crisis that's haunting our country. And it's become so serious that it's also the subject of an imaginary world, one night a year. A group of people in Queen Anne's County showed students the true terrors of the opioid epidemic through a haunted house.
Yes, yes. Kid just passed out. It's hard. We don't know what's going on.
Guys, is he breathing? Is he breathing?
I don't know.
What you're watching is a group of teenagers panicking as they watch first responders try to revive their friend who was overdosed on opioids.
Let them do what they need to do. Just stand back.
But this isn't real. These kids are students acting out a scene. But why they're doing it is very real.
Why not do something where people go through different scenes in the life of a drug abuser?
And it's all unfolding inside this haunted house.
And do that instead of scaring people with ghosts and goblins.
Court is now in session. You may be seated.
The people watching aren't the only ones haunted. So are the actors, who have been haunted by opioids in real life.
I myself am a recovering addict from heroin and fentanyl.
You know what I mean? What happened to you? This is what happened to me. You see that? From being out there in the street, this is what happened.
And before it unfolds on the streets, it starts in the most unsuspecting places. At home, in a kitchen.
Your dad did not give a rat's ass about us. He didn't love you, he doesn't love me, and that's why he's in jail, exactly where he belongs.
We know right now, after all the years of research, that addiction comes before the drug. So if you have a genetic predisposition, as I do in my family, if you have a history of trauma, whether it be sexual, emotional, physical abuse, all of those factors combined.
David Posey has been there. He's now a peer counselor helping others look ahead with hope, rather than look back with regret.
And it turned into a monster for me. You know, it was fun in the beginning, and then it became a job, and then it became a job. Because of like-minded people, I was able to see the common bond that we had, and I was able to start to embrace my recovery.
And that's what this program wants to do, reduce stigma and invite open discussion about opioids.
We're at a point in this nation where we've realized this is a situation that's not going to get any better, and we really have to take really innovative steps, and I think that's what we've tried to do here.
Those who visited the haunted house made a final stop before they left, to a resource room. There, they were offered access to addiction professionals and peer counselors in case they needed help after the experience.